Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Halo. Saya mau main-main dikit ya, boleh ya?
Bentar.
Saya mau foto. Hold up your hand. Angkat tangan kalian. Yang pria. Okay. Yes. I will speak in maybe in two languages or mix in three languages. My name is Ahmad. I am from Bogor. I was the openSUSE community members since 2009. I was starting using Linux in 2001, so you can imagine that actually I'm old. But yeah, some people in India says that I'm immortal. Okay, then I was the release manager of the plan on Linux. It's the local Linux distribution since 2005. Yeah, the first one is based on the Fedora, then the next based on Ubuntu and then move to the Debian. Why not based on openSUSE? Because it's not challenged. It's too easy to use openSUSE. I mean, it's too stable, it's good, yes, but for study, no challenge. Okay, then I was also the GNOME Foundation member since last 2 years ago. And I'm also the committee of ASEAN, so if there is a conference, I also have a phone to choose with this place. And then I'm the CEO of my own company, a small company about the software development. It's kind of a little bit a different software house because we not accept the easy project. For example, if there is some company ask, can you build the homepage or website for our company? No. Why? It's too easy. Sorry. Actually, easy means the salary is small, so it's not enough. So difficult means high salary. Okay. Then I was the heavy Linux evangelist. So all the computer in my house mostly using Linux. No Windows. In my parent also no Windows. So I'm still also my teammates. If you're using Windows, go outside. Yeah. And then this is my GitHub. Who doesn't have a GitHub account? Oh, siapa yang punya akun GitHub? Siapa yang punya akun GitHub? Who has a GitHub account? Who has the GitHub account? Oh, okay. And then the Facebook and Twitter. Yeah, this is about my school today. And actually, why we need to contribute to open source? Why? Kenapa kita harus pusing-pusing untuk kontribusi? Okay. This is about our culture, Indonesia culture, maybe especially a Japanese culture. Long, long time ago, there was a king.
Once upon a time.
Yeah, my ancestor is the king of the East Java king. We have a culture. It's called Gotong Royong. It's like a cooperation with the villager, with our neighbor. Mostly, it's common to building a house or the harvest time. Yeah, it looks like this. Or moving a house, for example, from one block to another block. Yeah, it's collaboration. This is our culture. It's still in some villages, but not in big cities. Now, even for women, we also have. So, no difference. Siapa yang kampungnya masih ada gotong royong kayak gini? Di kampungnya? Yeah, they still practice in their village. And they have a there is kind of a lot of a reason why we need to contribute. For me personally, I already have a lot of benefit of open source software. Before I use Linux, I only the type for someone. Yeah, if just simply you can challenge me, how fast you can type. If you can win against me, I will give you 1 million. Jadi sebelum saya kenal Linux, saya cuma tukang rental ketik, makanya kalau ketik cepet banget. Tukang fotokopi pernah, loker koran pernah. Some of people feeling that they contribute to FOSS, they can get a job. And then increase the personal value. I think it's many of people in here that contribute to FOSS can increase the personal value. Jadi bisa meningkatkan potensi diri. Bisa jadi potensi kemampuan, kecerdasan. Bisa jadi tambah narsis kayak macam dia gitu. Jadi tambah creepy gitu. Bisa jadi ya ada yang merasa tambah cakep macam-macam. Tapi yang dapat yang jomblo juga masih banyak di depan itu temennya juga. The other thing is create history. Jadi, what's the meaning create history? I was 2009 in another island. I teach people how to use computer. They doesn't know what is Linux, what is Windows, doesn't know. Even they use mouse, it's not very horizontal, but they try to fly it in the mouse. And now, mostly they can shopping online shopping. Okay. So, people in that island know me more, because I their teacher, they lecture, so I create history in that place. Jadi, kalau pakai open source, kita bisa dongeng kemana-mana. Dikenal banyak orang menciptakan sejarah bahwa kalian sudah pernah sini, kalian pernah gabung sebuah proyek besar. Apalagi ketika dipakai oleh orang-orang lain. Istilahnya ya, tambah keren lah. And then, communicate. Jadi, tidak semua orang itu bisa ngomong. Ada yang pemalu, ada yang malu-maluin. So, not every people can speak. Me too. First time, I'm really nervous speak in front of people. And my first time speak is in front of the 300 people. That's my first time. And yeah, this custom. Jadi, kesempatan kontribusi ini sebenarnya untuk memudahkan kita belajar komunikasi, ngomong antar teman. Karena saya menemui di tim saya itu, artinya memang nggak bisa ngomong sama temannya. Tapi kalau chatting, lancar.
Alek.
I don't think that I have a team that typical to speak each other. But when we chatting, it's perfect. Yeah, but with the contribution we can learn about how to communicate. Then, selanjutnya, learn from answering questions. Jadi kalau kita menghadapi pertanyaan di Facebook, di bilis, ada yang bingung, ada punya masalah bahwa komputernya nggak bisa nyala, dia nggak tahu kadang lupa powernya belum dicolok. Nah, kita kan nggak ngerti, oh ternyata komputer itu nggak bisa nyala kalau powernya belum dicolok. The next looks good. Ayo, siapa yang ngerasa kalau kontribusi ke FOSS itu jadi kelihatan keren? Angkat tangan. Good. Banyak. Nah, I will split the kind. There is a two kind of a problem, but actually different. There is obstacle and there is a problems. What is different? Obstacle means make your contribution less than the others. Jadi ini namanya hambatan. Ada hambatan, ada masalah. Kalau hambatan itu menghambat saja sementara atau membuat kontribusi kalian terlambat, teman-teman lebih kencengnya. Ada lagi yang masalah, masalah itu ya berhenti, nggak bisa. Contoh masalah apa? Nggak bisa kontribusi yang dasar, nanti aja jelaskan. Jadi yang ini hambatan. There is obstacle. For example, limited internet connection. This is the basic issue of the contribution in Indonesia. No internet connection. But in Jakarta maybe there is good internet connection. And then limited hardware. Some people think that their laptop is not good enough. They still have maybe single core with 1 GB RAM and they install it with a KDE file. Yeah. And then limited storage. Yeah, it's common. But actually for Linux, it's not the issue. You can install on your USB flash drive. Only 4 GB is okay. And then, it is common, the rest time. Because you have a family, you have a full-time job. Yeah, this is common. Many people say that I'm busy. And I answer, oh, are you busy? Me, I'm more busy than you. I'm traveling around the city to another every day more. I also have a family. I also have a lot of people to take care. Yeah, I'm more busy actually. So prepare your time, manage your time. Sometimes it's need 1 hour to contribute in 1 week. But people say that they doesn't have time. And then less knowledge. Some people say I'm not clever enough. I cannot code, for example. Jadi nggak semua orang kan, saya nggak bisa kontribusi, saya nggak bisa ngoding. Gampang, mau kontribusi, cari pacar tentang ngoding.
Ya kan? Saya dapat satu loh.
Jadi nggak, ketika kontribusi itu nggak semuanya harus ngoding banyak. You can be a designer, you can be a documentation team, or bug buster, berubah. And it's happened in 2 days ago, the last thing. Somebody broke your laptop. Yeah, it's happened in my team 2 days ago. So then it was a bug. I report and I say, please fix it tomorrow. And the developer said, sorry, there is someone borrow my laptop. Boys or girl? And said, girls. So this is also the obstacle. If your girlfriend or your boyfriend borrow your laptop, it's obstacle. I think it's better that maybe you can change your boyfriend or okay, there is also problems. Problems mean you will stop to contribute. Yeah. For example, die more dearly. Yeah, it's stop. And then family reason. Yeah, sometimes you getting old, you need to move to another place for your family, focus on your family, yeah. So it's okay. And then overwork. Some people say that his main job, the salary is not enough, so they need to get another job as a part-time job and you doesn't have time. It's common. Jadi normal, kadang ngerasa gajinya nggak cukup. Jadi harus cari sampingan, jadi misalnya jadi tukang ojek online. Aku nggak nyebut sponsor ini. Jadi misalnya kayak gitu, sah-sah aja. Cuma kalau menurut saya lebih baik cari kerjaan lain deh. Maksudnya berhenti dari kerjaan yang utama tadi, nyari kerjaan gajinya lebih tinggi. So, ya, kira-kira apa lagi ya masalahnya? Yang kira-kira berhenti kontribusi. Pacarnya galak. Okay. This is the main reason why stop contributing. And then, what's the benefit? Apa manfaat jika kita berkontribusi? Knowledge. Yeah, this is my main reason. I was nothing. Aku hanya butiran debu. I was laughing in 2001 until 2008. Then I meet the community. They teach me about using Linux as a system administrator. And then, yeah, basically I know the Visual Basic and Microsoft.NET or something like that. But it's not interesting because it's not easy to find a job with the Microsoft platform at that time. I was trying to apply some vacancy and they said, can you use Linux? Okay, then, and it's not it. I am admin online. So my first distro is openSUSE. SUSE, at that time still SUSE. Yeah, I am the admin and he teach me and yeah, I'm good enough. Then friendship, you meet people, each other, meet Dov, Hibari, meet the Omojan, Takayama, Hatori-chan, meet every people in here. We have a lot of friends. Some of them maybe have wife from open source, meets another to be a girlfriend or yeah, it's weird. Yeah, I see a lot of GNOME developers like that. And both of them are developers in GNOME. I say, how you can marry each other? Ah, because we are developers. Oh, okay. Jadi dapat jodoh. Nggak percaya, tanya depan anak-anak di sini. Ada yang pengalaman. Ya, kesempatan job opportunity. Sekarang ini tren kalau pakai open source atau Linux itu pasti kesempatan bekerjanya jauh lebih baik. Kalau nggak percaya, coba aja ngelamar ke Google, pasti disuruh set up Linux duluan. Ada perusahaan, beberapa perusahaan di Jakarta itu mandatory kalau pakai Linux pasti. Karena mayoritas 95 server itu Linux. Jadi harus bisa. Ya, getting married. And the last one, this is the nice one. Travel around the world, visiting another countries and the culture. Jadi yang terakhir ini bonus, bisa keliling-keliling dunia. Saya dulu menargetkan untuk melihat Seven Wonder, sudah terwujud beberapa. Jadi my personal benefit is to travel around the world. I dreaming to visiting Seven Wonders. And already helped. So, see you next year in Manchester. Okay, how to contribute? Jadi bagaimana cara berkontribusi? As a personal, as a group or communities, as a company or startup, and as government. What I can write in for? Because I also as a personal, I also as community groups, I also have a company, and I also helping government or military to do their things. Okay, personal. How to contribute personal? Support your local communities. Jadi dukung komunitas lokal kalian, bantu-bantuin. Kalau ada acara event kayak gini, gabung aja nih bro. Minimal dapat makan gratis. Minimal dapat kaos gratis. So. Ya, yeah, yeah, support your local communities, local events. Create events. Jika nggak ada kegiatan, ya bikin. Yang keren. Minimal dapat job gratis lagi. Bisa foto-foto. Syukur-syukur dapat judul. Okay, then others help desk at social media. Many people will ask about their problems, so you can help to answer it. The next step to be a FOSS developer. Jadi naik pangkat jadi developer, nggak hanya sebagai user. Kamu ingat tadi nggak hanya coding, bisa desain, bisa gambar dan sebagainya. And then translation. The great things of to be an Indonesia citizen is we have 1,212 local language. Yeah, yeah, you can see in Wikipedia. It's weird. So you can translate from English to Indonesia, English to Java, English to the Sundanese and the others. Jadi enak kan? Nerjemahin ke Jawa, apa enggak? kira-kira? Salah. Jadi ini nih, misalnya, terjemahin. It, terjemahannya apa? Kalau sing mangan, ini Jawa Timuran badok. Gak mau dia tuh ini terjemahannya. Ini yang mana nih? It's difficult. Actually, you need, because translation, you will study culture, history. For example, Java language. One word, different use case, different level how to use. For example, if we have a meaning makan, selamat makan, makan. Okay. If we talk with the parents, it's also use a different word. Talk with the bastard, we also use different word. So yeah, you need to study more. So it's not only about the IT person, it's also about the language person, language professional, translation. Nerjemah juga gitu. Kemarin teman-teman dari Surabaya mau nerjemahkan misalnya Gunung atau Blangkon ke Jawa Timuran. Kalau error, mosok jawabnya matamu suwe cuk. Gak gampang, salah. Okay. The last thing is commitment and consistent, continue juga. Jadi yang terakhir ini berat. Kalian boleh ganti pacar 4 kali, tapi bakalan susah untuk ganti distro 2 kali. Contoh saya udah ganti istri 2 kali. Tapi kena kutukan belakon. Ya udah, gak bisa ganti distro. Kayaknya sampai mati deh. Oke. Komitmen, yang terakhir. Selalu kontinu, terus kontribusi. Walaupun sedikit, walaupun cuma ngopi bareng, itu kontribusi. Karena selalu update dengan informasi. Kontribusi to groups. Sama dengan yang pribadi, create FOSS event. Meet each other. Membantu developer. Helping companies. Membantu perusahaan tentang implementasi open source, nggak gratis, dibayar. Jangan mau kalau gratis. Then helping government, membantu pemerintah. Kita boleh mengkritik pemerintah itu, boleh bebas saja mengkritik, tapi juga kita harus bantuin. Terserah mau gratis apa enggak, tapi kalau bisa jangan gratis. And then also translation, jadi bikin workshop yang banyak. Tentang apa? Menerjemahkan tadi, bikin tim. Dulu pernah ada Blangkon Banyumas, translasi Blangkon di bahasa Banyumas. Ngapa? Aku mau satu aja gak bisa. Gak ngerti. Tapi ini kayaknya udah mudah juga, udah musnah. Jadi kalau ada yang mau misalnya bikin distro atau apa, translasikan. Misalnya di Provis, pakai bahasa Jawa, level 1 Jogja lah dipakai Kromo mungkin. Seru juga itu. Seru juga itu benar. Nah, groups community, you can see the picture. This is the Indonesia. The Java Island is about 1,000 kilometers, and for me, from Bogor to Yogyakarta is about 600 or 700 kilometers with travel. And that guy is from the Makassar. It's another island. It's about 3,000 kilometers to here. Yeah. Ada lagi yang dari luar Jawa? Angkat tangan. Dari mana? Medan. Wah, this is another island. 4,000 kilometers. Yang dari Bantul, Sopo. Yeah. And mostly every city, every town is also has a little community. Mostly in Indonesia. So I say to you, last night that I have a hobby to travel with motorbike, so I can visit each other and have a free lunch because they pay my food. So you can travel around the world, meet the Linux community. Okay, contribution as company startup. The example is my own company maybe. I use the FOSS products, everything, myself, even the operating system, some of them using openSUSE, some of them using Debian. And we give a feedback. Jadi kita pakai untuk server. Kalau ada bug kita report. Kalau bisa memperbaiki, fix it and push to GitHub. For example, we do the EGBCA. There is some bugs and we submit the GitHub and they approve. Be sponsored. Jadi kalau punya startup, jangan pelit-pelit. Buang-buang duit, gitu. Jangan. Aja-aja developer untuk makan-makan. Buy some food for developer, for example. Jadi sponsor event, be sponsor events. Donate to developer. For example, FOSS. We have a special SUSE. It is conference, yeah. Or hiring developers. Jadi menggaji developers. Buat apa misalnya? Buat ngerjain Ubuntu, satu paket saja. Di platform ada 6 orang kerja untuk platform. Dibayar. Kurang enak apa? Sopo yang tertarik sih developer? Kurang sih tertarik kan? Padahal laptopnya api-api. Hiring developers. And then contribution in government side. Siapa yang PNS? Ada yang PNS gak? Wah, gak ada. Gak seru. There is no government officer. Oh, PNS. Government officer. Ya. Yeah. Government officer can promoting FOSS and then implementing FOSS and create FOSS products. Menciptakan produk open source. And co-work with communities. For example, our sponsor, Ministry of Information, we create the Kominfo PKI, WebSDKI, is about the public key infrastructure. It's like a toolkit. Now it's trending topic of digital signature certificate, like SSL. And Indonesia right now have on the root CA. How we collaborate with the local communities? Ministry work with the plan on distribution. To create some like a sample project, you can type to your laptops data.blankon.id. It must be the HTTPS, it must be red, a file. But if you use blankon, it will be green. Jadi contoh kerjaannya adalah kita kan bikin sertifikat digital SSL. SSL ini kalau tidak terautentikasi, tidak dikenali, pasti merah, silang. Kalau nggak percaya, buka handphone, masuk data blankon.id, pasti silang. Tapi kalau kalian pakai blankon, aman pasti hijau. So, it because we put the root CA into our Linux distribution. Government doesn't know how to do it, actually. They need our help. So the next step is how to make all the browser use that root CA. Yeah, for example, we can collaborate with the Mozilla communities and maybe with the openSUSE or SUSE. I think if the developer of SUSE have time to talk with the ministry, I think it's good. For example, how to promote this root CA to the openSUSE. Me, I really doesn't know how to do that in SUSE side. What we doing, what the steps. I can help the government to as a teaching. So it's now is used in every government office. So they need to use. Merah kan? Sudah pernah nyoba? Nah, dongeng saya cuma ini. Jadi that's all for me. But I need more, I hope. There will be a discussion, jadi ada tanya jawab dari kalian. Ngeluh pakai Linux susah juga gak apa-apa. Saya ingin ada tanya jawab. Jadi itu saja dari saya. Thank you very much.